barely surviving. Watching me living through me, so I gotta stay thriving. This shit a privilege, not promise. Dead honest, cause I can't let shit live on my conscience. To multiply, give it my undivided. You gotta move fast, think faster. Lately, my life been a lot of losses and less laughter. To paint the picture, I can't look the same in my before and afters. Honestly, I probably gonna be booked till I'm on the next chapter. Signed a slave deal, now a nigga up on in my
bastard. Hey everybody, I'm Joseph, aka Rockstar Joe, and welcome to episode 23 of a Blerd's Intermission podcast. As always, you know, I hope you all are doing well. It's been a week since we've last sat and listened to each other, so I'm glad to have you back, you know, listening again. Today's episode, got a few topics that I want to talk about. Well, yes, the usual Blerd talk is going to be here. Along with the usual Blerd talk, I want to, you know, continue that conversation that I've been talking about for the past couple of weeks regarding the homicide rates in DC. Along with that, I want to share some, you know, Halloween fun, aka reminisce on a few stories surrounding Halloween, and then kind of close this out talking about the election. So yeah, got a few topics in hand, so let's get down with it, because got a lot of shit to share with you guys. So starting with, you know, my movies, added a lot to the collection this past weekend. So as far as actual like movies go, I've only added Borat 2. I forgot the actual name of it, but for my notes, I just put it as Borat 2. So I've added that to the collection, and then I added a bunch of documentaries to my you know, documentary folder. Starting with Feel Good's, well, sorry, starting with Feels Good Man. This documentary is about how an animated frog becomes a symbol of hate. To understand what I'm saying or reading, at least with this one, just Google it. You'll understand it. Once you see the actual frog, you'll be like, oh, that's the meme frog. You'll get it. Next, we have Pretending I Am Superman, Tony Hawk. So this documentary basically dives into the effect that Tony Hawk has had on his skateboarding world, as well as video games. Stolen Daughters. This documentary is about the freed women that were held as hostages of Boko Haram. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. After that, we have The Disrupted, which is about the American experience of financial challenges, family resilience, and the quest for the purpose and dignity of work. After that, I kind of dive into my black documentaries. Yes, I do have a folder specifically for black documentaries. I love my people, so kiss my ass if you're judging. But for this folder, I've added John Lewis, Good Trouble. That's self-explanatory, honestly. And then I've added Miles Davis, Birth of the Cool. So this one, you know, you have musicians, scholars, family, and friends that basically reflect on the life of Miles Davis and, you know, reveal the man behind the legend. After this, we have Pigeon Kings, which explores the subculture of men in South Central LA who train pigeons as a competitive sport. Sounds funny, but I think this is going to be an incredible documentary once I have the time to sit down and look at that. After that, we have Time. Fox Rich fights for the release of her husband, Rob, who is serving a 60-year sentence in prison. That's all I have to say. Definitely go check that out. And then next we have Uncle Tom, which is about an oral history of the American black conservative, which sounds very interesting. Makes sense for the title to be Uncle Tom, but let's keep it moving. The next three, I think they're going to have me extremely emotional. But up next we have What Killed Michael Brown, a documentary about a young black man who was killed by a police officer after he attacked the officer. This is a true story that the media does not want you to know. Next, we have Yusuf Hawkins, Storm Over Brooklyn. This takes a look at the events surrounding the murder of Yusuf Hawkins, a black teenager in Brooklyn who was killed by a group of white boys. And last but not least, and I was already watching part of this documentary before I started recording, but Time, the Khalif Browder story. So this documentary is one of my favorites, but it's also one of the more emotional documentaries that'll, you know, have me tearing up. This documentary takes a look at the life of Khalif and his wrongful conviction. He was sentenced, you know, and put it fucking, he was put on, what's the island, Rikers Island, for a crime he didn't commit. So, you know, I fucked it up with the whole speech. But seriously, if you don't take a look at any of these documentaries or movies that I mentioned over the course of this podcast, take the time out to look at this story, because this story, man, it could be any one of us. For my brothers, this definitely for you. This can definitely be one of us. But pushing ahead for TV shows, you know, last week one of my favorite TV shows, Lovecraft Country, you know, came to an end, but it's okay. I'm still gangsta. I'm still gonna carry on. But the latest series that I've downloaded that I need to watch at some point would be Mr. Robot. If you know it, you know it. If not, as usual, Google that shit, okay? moving along for books and comics. So I'm still reading, you know, Charlemagne the God's Black Privilege. Trying to fucking prepare for this whole GRE and just, you know, stay afloat on these other things that I'm trying to take care of. It's just really difficult for me to sit down in this house and just read. So instead of me reading it, I'm just going to listen to it. I managed to get my hands on the audiobook. So, yeah, we'll see how that goes. But nonetheless, keeping it moving. I've also added even more books to my collection as well. I'm just going to share the title of them. No author, nothing like that, but just naming them, getting them out the way. So I've also added the autobiography of Malcolm X, The Mind Illuminated, The Secret, Out of My Skull, The Psychology of Boredom, Michelle Obama's Becoming, and when I start thinking about it too hard, I fuck it up too much. So once again, The Autobiography of Malcolm X, The Mind Illuminated, The Secret, Out of My Skull, The Psychology of Boredom, Michelle Obama's Becoming, and Digital Minimalism are the books that I recently added. See how well that went? Wasn't thinking about it. There we go. Anxiety, get out of my face. But yeah, that's it with books. Comics, I didn't really down. Well, technically I did. So I kind of mapped out the next couple of reads that I'll be, you know, finishing. So I still got to finish up Excellence. After that, I want to finish reading Infinity Gauntlet, and then after that, I want to finish the House of M series. So I've also managed to get that, but also with some of the actual, I guess, main characters and their realities due to the whole House of M events. But yeah, just sharing that with you all. Pushing through. Music. There were a few artists that did release some things, but I was just like, I'm not interested this week. These two artists, which would definitely get my support, don't get it twisted, but Junior Lucas released another album, and Ty Dolla $ign. That man just had too many features for me to want to listen, but I do hope, you know, his album gets the success that it deserves. If you haven't already, though, you know, go check out my project, Intermission, The Intro to Meraki, available on all streaming platforms. Would greatly appreciate it. I can give a fuck less about the money right now. I just want to get my message across. We've done an exceptional job of basically getting this podcast overseas, you know, even though it's just one person in France. I'm definitely optimistic of it, you know, becoming two and then it growing in a snowball effect. So, you know, what I'm trying to say is I can give a fuck less about the money that I make off the album. What really touches my heart and which warms my heart and could, you know, make me happy is that you share with another friend, and your friend becomes a fan, and the cycle, you know, repeats. You know, I really do want to build up this fan base to be able to communicate more with you all. Sheesh. Should drink some water on that one, but would love to communicate with you all and, you know, build up this community of supporters, you know, because I'm ready to take some more risks, man. But pushing through, as far as my throwback Sundays, so I don't know if people know this by now, but, you know, I love hip hop, by all means. I love hip hop. It's not because I'm black, but I love hip hop. But, you know, I really tapped back into my rock roots this past weekend. So I didn't really, you know, dive too hard into the hip hop and R&B. I dived into my rock. So some of the artists that, you know, I managed to get some of their music, I guess, consist of Green Day. I'm quite sure if you don't know, man, if you don't know who they are, I think you may be too young, which is kind of strange, but we're going to talk about that. Anyway, Green Day, 3 Days Grace, and Fleetwood Mac. Yeah, those are the artists that I was listening to. Fleetwood Mac. I didn't realize, like, how old the band was, though. And I didn't realize they created so many hits. Like, shit that you just hit in the background that you don't give any thought. Like, okay, I got you. But, yeah, shouts out to them. As for video games, yeah, I just finished paying off my Watchdog Legions that also comes out tomorrow, which I'm super excited about. But by the time this was released, it'll be out today, so I'm super excited. By the time you're listening to this, I have probably spent at least a solid hour or two playing it, but pushing through. Speaking of, you know, games though, it's definitely about to get crazy. I didn't realize we had so many releases coming up, but I'm sorry, so many releases coming up. So I know for November 10th, we have Assassin's Creed Valhalla. On the 12th, we have Spider-Man Miles Morales. Originally, on the 19th, we were supposed to get Cyberpunk, but just yesterday, I saw the news that they pushed back the game until December 10th, but it's like, cool. Then you have Call of Duty Cold War. It's like, I don't know. To me, Call of Duty kind of goes into the whole Madden and 2K series. Like, same shit, different year. Slight, you know, slight adjustments and all that great shit. But chances are I'm talking shit about it. But I already know myself. At some point, I'm going to, you know, go ahead, get that Call of Duty. Get online, spank some ass. Like I said, if anybody want that work, hit your boy up. But, yeah. Also, so another dope game. Some old dope games that I want to get. I know for, December, I think December 1st, there's a game called, is it Empire of Sin? That looks like a dope game. And then there's a game that just came out yesterday called Ghost Runner. I think that's like $30. Both of these games are like $30 or $40, but, yeah, definitely trying to get my hands on these games, man. Continue to be inspired, get these ideas, continue to expand and go into other people's worlds as well. But yeah, that's it with the whole usual Blerd talk. We get it longer and longer with these segments. I'm loving this. Pushing through. So now that we're done with the usual Blerd talk, can get in more into these topics. Give me a second while I drink some water. So yeah, as I was saying, getting into the two topics or topics that I had mentioned at the beginning of the show. So with this week, I'm giving y'all two episodes. You know, this episode is your regular, you know, usual Blerd's Intermission type of episode. And then the next one is more so focused on Intermission, the intro to Meraki, that album. I just want to, you know, share some Easter eggs and just some of the facts of the project that, you know, most people don't know about. So, yeah. But, diving into this whole homicide shit, man. Sheesh, yo. Picking up on the last episode regarding homicides in DC. So, the last time I recorded, like, the last exact time that I recorded, the exact date, within that day, that time span, 7 different people were shot in DC. I think there was like out of 7 shootings, there was like 1 or 2 fatalities, I believe. But yeah, I don't know. I'm not gonna say I'm scared or worried, but I fear that as soon as I'm done with this episode, the same shit gonna happen again. I'm gonna come across a Fox 5 article or, you know, the Instagram post of just another senseless killing or some shit, man. But I was also made aware of another killing that took place, but this one had took place this past Friday. Karan Hilton, I pray that I'm announcing this right, was allegedly chased and pursued by MPD, and he was struck. He was struck while riding a moped. There has been no camera footage, you know, released from the police department just yet, but I have seen videos of, you know, protesters going up to the 4th district and, you know, letting their voice be heard. I did see that someone or some people did attempt and did break a window within that facility. But, I mean, what you expect? What you expect, yo? You know, all hell definitely broke loose. Via Twitter, I did see an image of the mother, Karan's mother was, you know, being pepper sprayed. So I don't know what to say about that. You know, rest in peace. Once again, another fucking father gone. Another kid left fatherless. Just fucking sad. I wish news like this was surprising, you know? But it's just like, man, here's another one. Here's a fucking another one. And then, you know, while I'm speaking on this shit, I gotta be honest with myself. I can give a fuck less of repercussions happening. But I am so fucking tired of seeing people say, fuck 12, fuck the law, fuck the pigs. It's like, how long have y'all motherfuckers been saying the same shit? At what point do you just shut up and just speak with action? Like, allow your actions to speak for you. That's the same shit. We get killed. Oh, fuck him. Fuck the law. Da, 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 da. At what point will you step the fuck up and go? Fuck a protest. Fuck you putting your hands up. When you gonna go back and do what you gotta do? I get tired of seeing this shit. At what point will white people take us seriously as black people? As African Americans, whatever you want to call yourself, you're still a part of the same fucking group. At what point will we stop saying the same shit? Because for me, it's like you can only say the same shit until shit just gets tiring. And at the age of 25, I'm tired of being sad. I'm tired of seeing the fucking hashtags. I'm tired of these fucking officers getting away with the shit. Like, bro, these are humans too. They can still get the same bullets that they fucking shoot out they fucking gun. They can still be hurt and harmed. They don't deserve to still walk around with the freedom that they have, know what the fuck they did. I ain't encouraging violence, but at the same time, I'm not encouraging silence either. Fuck that shit, man. I understand, you know, people have different ways of coping mechanisms and shit like that, but y'all motherfuckers don't ever get tired of talking. Like, I get tired of hearing the same shit, bro. I really do. Fuck him. Fuck 12. They played with my mans. They did this in my mans. Meanwhile, you still didn't let them do that shit. But let it be another nigga that look just like you on the fucking streets. You're going to be so quick to retaliate and fuck them up. Apply that same shit, bro. Don't be a bitch. Just because they got a badge don't make shit different, bro. Fuck that. If you're going to fight for your people, fight for your people. If you're going to stand your fucking ground, stand your fucking ground. Don't keep talking. Keep talking. Fuck. At this point, never mind. It is what it is, man. It is what it is. Change is going to come one way or another, but it is what it is. I'll dive into that another day. Or better yet to say, I'm for truth no matter who tells it. I'm for justice no matter who it is for or against. It's a better way to put that. But that's all I'll say on that topic. You know, making things a bit more lighter. Halloween, yo. Halloween is right around the corner. Actually, Halloween is what? Tomorrow, Friday, sir. Damn, 3 days away, man. I don't know. Halloween's gonna be different this year. Just to share some of the experiences that I've had. Like, I remember there was this one year I was in high school. This was when, you know, all the guys were together. This was when you had your clique and your group of friends, your mans and shit. And I remember you used to always, like, make Georgetown a destination Because Georgetown be booming, bruh. All the motherfucking mansions. All them rich folks having money. All the candy that's being left down there. All the people you get to see. The dresses. The outfits. Like, it's a fucking fashion show. It's a hot spot. It's everything. I remember on multiple occasions just different experiences. Just to share one funny one. But I feel like I'm going to be very honest and brutal. So I'll probably be sad by the very end. But I remember one year. It was all of us. Me and the guys. Yeah, so anyway. We're down Georgetown. There's a couple that's coming towards us. Not like approaching or talking to us or anything. But you know how Georgetown roads be. It's like very, very narrow. So, you know. Sometimes you got to be claustrophobic on that bitch. But anyway. They're making their way towards us, right? So they pass by, right? Nothing happens. One of my friends is like, yo, that guy looks like your dad. I was like, guess what, y'all? That was my father. They was like, what the fuck? So what I'm saying is, one Halloween, and keep in mind, I've said the relationship that me and my father has grown to have over the years and me growing up. But, yeah, I was fucking trick-or-treating, you know, grown. Well, I can't even say grown-ass man. I was still in high school. But trick-or-treating, like a young man. And walked right past each other. I don't think we said shit. I don't think we did. He was with his girl. I was with my friends. And it's like, he literally treated me like I was just a regular bystander. And, you know, my friends at the time just broke out laughing. It was like, what the fuck? So, yeah, that's my father, you guys. Yeah, what nigga walks past his kid on Halloween and don't say shit to him? My dad. But that's cool. That's cool. Another story, man, there's been so many stories. I remember, like, there's one mansion that just left a gigantic ass pot of candy. I know that shit was gone real quick. Niggas was greedy. I remember also having spray paint one year, tagging somebody's car. I didn't do it. Just gonna put that out there, but you know, you're gonna skip over that. But yeah, Georgetown, man, just used to be the spot. I remember later portions of like going to Halloween or trick-or-treating down Georgetown, shit did really become a hotspot. Niggas started getting shot. Fights started breaking out. I remember one year there was a kid that actually got shot in the head, I believe, down Georgetown. Because, you know, everybody want to come with their hood, stunt, pose, start shit, and then run from shit. And, you know, that's how it was. But just always try to stay away from the bullshit. You know what I mean? But, yeah, this year, I don't know. So, yeah, but I also remember being a kid, not like a baby, but definitely like younger than 8 or 9, I think. And I remember my brother's godfather, he was a student at the University of Maryland. He was like Chinese or Asian. My apologies, I don't know which one is which when describing him. But I remember, man, he just picked us up from D.C. We went all the way to College Park, and it's like, we went to this fucking building. Every level had a fucking party. Like, the shit was beautiful, man. Oh, man, I wish colleges. Man, I wish COVID wasn't here, bro. I wish it wasn't here. And then, I don't know, thinking about some other stories. Like, I guess for, like, the past 3 or 4 years, like, it's just been me and Jakayla. Whether it was her and I in a relationship and, you know, the other couple comes along, or if it's just, not the other couple, but, you know, my significant other and her child comes along. But lately, it's just been, you know, me and her. And it's been fun, especially for, like, the last two. Because I managed to, like, you know, I'm still in class and still in college. But I'll definitely, you know, get off from school, get off from work and come and pick her up. And then take her back on campus and let her see what's up. And then, you know, with her, she all fake shy. Because everybody like, oh, my God, you look beautiful. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. You know. She'd be hyping her head up, man. I swear she'd be faking sometimes, but yeah, you know, her dressing up, everybody just like, oh my God, that's your daughter. Like, yeah, motherfucker, that ain't my sister. So, yeah, man, just, oh man, I remember those, man. So many times, just every time was beautiful. She'd be so pressed to go on campus. I swear she'd be, but, yeah, damn, man. I think this year, I don't know. I think this year, it's maybe the first year in a while where we're not trick-or-treating together. I think she should be around, but yeah, we're not At least on this end, we're not trick-or-treating. I ain't playing that shit. I don't got time to be trick-or-treating, getting no COVID or no COVID. Nah, I'm good. I'll stay away. I'll stay my ass in the house. I'll dress up, put my little astronaut suit on, flight suit on, light my motherfucking purge mask, and enjoy the night, I guess. Pushing ahead. Last but not least with this topic, elections. So, well, before I transition on that, I definitely want to say, you know, if you do trick-or-treat this year, be safe. My advice that you don't, but nonetheless, if you do, just be safe, be mindful, and enjoy, I guess. But pushing ahead to the elections, so I don't know how I really feel. There's a part of me that believes, like, Biden and Harris may win. But then there's also a part of me that's like, ooh, this nigga Trump may be in this bitch 4 more years. And if I'm honest, I do have a what if for both. But if Trump remains president, I promise you, I'm definitely going to go ahead and get my gun license. Because I just know shit's going to get crazy. I know it is. But I'm also, you know, just move differently. 4 more years with Trump, man, you can imagine the amount of racist motherfuckers. Bigotry, just hate, discrimination, the amount of that shit. I feel like that shit is going to raise like twice as high, you know. But once again, I'm an optimistic person, but some real shit though. I'm going to be prepared just in case if he becomes president. Now, if he loses and Biden and Harris wins, I will be extremely happy for 10 minutes. Because then I'm like, ugh, we got Biden and Harris, not Harris and someone else. Because this is how I see it. Like, this is who I'm voting for. I'm voting for Harris. If it wasn't for Harris being on the fucking ballot and being in a Democratic Party, I promise you, I wouldn't be voting this year. I wouldn't. I didn't want to vote last time, 4 years ago, when we had Hillary and Trump. I didn't want to. It's like, both of these motherfuckers corrupt. Both of these motherfuckers just, like, bullshit. It's like, I don't trust neither one. One motherfucker got hidden emails. Another one got hidden fucking accounts overseas. There's so much bullshit. So, yeah. But if Biden and Harris wins, I definitely do think the momentum of just all this hatred in the U.S. can make a real switch around, or pull around, quick around, whatever the fuck we call it. I really do hope, you know, I do hope this isn't a repeat of 2016. Because I remember that day. I remember that night. That next day. I remember that shit. I thought class was supposed to be canceled. No, they said, nope, bring your ass to school. I remember. I was trying to stay up. I was like, yeah, Hillary's going to win. By the time I woke up, they was like, Trump won. I was like, whoa. Just the whole feeling of being on an HBCU when Trump won was just, It was awkward as fuck. It was depressing as fuck. It was a sad day. It was a sad day in class. I'll never forget that shit. Motherfuckers were like really voicing their opinion, but like, yo, I'm scared. Like, I'm afraid. I don't know what these white people are gonna do. And you know, you see what they have done. But I don't know, man. I really do hope we get this one, because either way, my shit's still going to remain independent. I don't care for the Republicans, and I damn sure don't care for the Democrats. Motherfuckers flip-floppy, wish-washy. At this point, I don't know. Politics isn't for me. But, yeah, man, that's pretty much it. We talked about everything. So, yeah. I'm not sure what else to say. Yeah, I don't know. I guess the next time you guys hear from me will be next week and after the election. So if I had to be optimistic and, you know, a politician, I would definitely go say, go vote, ladies and gentlemen. But nah, all jokes aside, if you're eligible, please go vote. Please go fucking vote. I would love to see the statistics of this year, and I would love to see that fucking meme or picture of like, oh my god, this was the best turnout for young voters that the election has ever seen. Like, I would love to see that. You know, as much as I am pessimistic when it comes to politics, I do believe that, you know, a lot of these votes do count. I wish every vote did count, but, you know, the electoral colleges and all these bullshit ass fucking disruptors and people that's trying to fuck up the election. I just hope we come out strong. Like, I want to be able to have a J in hand, enjoying my vibe, smiling, laughing, like, yay, we got Harris in there. We got the first black woman president, vice president in there, you know? But if we don't, you know, we'll talk about that next episode. But, this should be a very interesting week. You will definitely be able to tell how either excited or how disappointed I am by the tone of my voice on the next episode. I promise you that. But, for now, this is it, ladies and gentlemen. Be safe. Be wise. Go vote. And, take care of yourself. Until next time. Peace.